it feels like I'm home. It feels like family because you understand. And I think that this prize being given to Familias Unidas and to community proves that you understand. So when you recognize farm workers, you recognize an almost invisible workforce and a forgotten part of the food system all across America. In every rural area and in every place almost where people are actually looking at the food system as a system, we are not one of the components or the stakeholders or the voices that people look to include when you're talking about a food system. And certainly, being farm worker women, our organization has been very vocal in trying to get recognition of the farm workers in the food system. Community to Community is a place-based, women-led organization. We're an equal, thank you. We are intentionally so, and we are an eco-feminist organization that looks to the earth in the solutions and in all of our fights, that Mother Earth is part of everything that we are working on, and that she talks to us, and she gives us signals, and she gives us opinions of what is happening. And I think as family farmers and other food justice activists, you know that Mother Earth has been telling us for a long time, things are going in the wrong direction. As farm workers, we have been among the first to see what the corporate food regime has had planned for the food system since the 1950s. Cesar Chavez spoke about it. He fasted, trying to get the attention of consumers and local governments and politicians about what the agri corporations were doing, about the profit that was looked to for in the future, the investment that was being made in the production of what he called economic poisons, pesticides and chemicals. He called those economic poisons because he saw them as a new product that was encompassing everything, the air and the water, the soil, the people especially. As farm workers, he knew that these economic poisons were hurting the farm workers working in the fields in Central Valley of California, and from there it just grew. And so as farm workers, we see the first of everything that is being done in the food system. Everything from mechanization of harvesting and production, from the economic poisons that are being used, to so-called efficiency production methods, to this new piece rate wage process, which is not just an hourly wage, but is a new way of paying production workers so that we can work beyond our endurance, so that we can work beyond what the human body can produce or should be able to do in the harvesting of fruits. This is one of the reasons that farm workers still, the average lifespan of a farm worker is still 49 years in the United States. If you are a farm worker and you work in the current system, then your lifespan is not over 50. It's 49 years, between 49 and 54 if you're lucky. Patricio is here, he's 20 years old. If he continues in this system, half of his life has already passed before him, 8 years of a professional production worker in the current system. I'm here to thank you for recognizing farm workers in the food system, for making us an equitable part of who you are and how you look at food production in America today. Thank you for giving us the dignity of recognizing that farm workers are in the United States and that we are under an attack that limits our mobility, our ability to survive, and limits our ability to produce opportunities for our children in your communities. We are everywhere in America today where food is being produced. Brothers and sisters and mentors, like the ones we just saw, our survival is woven into your well-being. We will die first and have been dying first from the chemicals, from the poison, toxins, from the production methods being used by corporate agriculture. But you are next, because everything that happens to us goes through our hands and into the boxes and into the retail outlets and the food that everybody in America buys. You are not only eating the economic poisons, but you are also eating despair and pain and poverty in the way that food is being produced. So we are tied together. We are tied together in local economies, in the production, but also through spirit and through the belief that has been expressed here that this food system is ours. That we not only should be eating the food, but we should have a voice and a decision into how the food is being produced in our community. And so, we are proud of the Food Sovereignty Prize because of the word sovereignty. When you look at the definition, sovereignty means autonomy, independence, self-determination, and freedom. We sit here in the shadows of corporate agriculture and the corporate food regime as a people that's looking towards the sovereignty of our food system because that is tied to the sovereignty of ourselves. Because it's about ourselves as a community and standing together. And that is why we're asking you and we're talking to you today about a boycott that many people see as negative and the wrong thing to do, that there must be nicer ways to do this and positive ways to come to an agreement. But the corporate food regime is looking at profit. And in a model that is all about profit, then what the only thing we have as farm workers is the right to try to put a barrier between their profit and us to get them to a table to listen to us and to try to change the way that they're doing profit. And I ask you that the solution to what is happening in the food system is not with politicians, it is not even in the current systems that are here, but it is with us. And it is in this interruption of the flow of the profit to the corporations that we can have an impact. And then together we must look at that. What can we do? The farm workers have said really clearly to us, until Sukuma Brothers Berry Farm sits down and negotiate, they will follow through with this boycott and we can do it together. But that is only a beginning. It is hopefully an inspiration for all of you to fight back even harder than you've been fighting against what is happening to our land and to our communities. You talk about, in the farm worker community, we talk about si se puede, we say the words, President Obama said it, but si se puede in the farm worker community means to us the perseverance to continue forward, to never turn around, to never go back, but to keep going forward, como dicen los campesinos, hasta el fin. Like the farm worker said, until it is done. And we don't know what that is, but it will be done, and we will not stop, and we will not go back until there is food sovereignty. We stand shoulder to shoulder with family farmers because we need to be shoulder to shoulder with family farmers. We will be with you, and we'll be with you in spirit in the fight until there is food sovereignty, and we will have the Food Sovereignty Prize will be so-called normalized or institutionalized in our community. Thank you very much for this wonderful prize and recognition from all of the farm workers everywhere. Si se puede. You know there's a group of workers that need support here locally, right? There's a group of workers, they're right here with us. They need the support in your own backyard. We will help them, and you have to say that you will help them too, because those hogs are not being treated right either, but these are the workers that are watching it, and they need your support too. Thank you very much.